Bonjour à tous, j'espère que vous allez bien. Je regarde qui est là. Comme d'habitude, je vais vous dire bonjour. Oh yeah, it would be in English today. So I will say hello to everybody. Luciana Moribe is with us. Gordon is here. One Life is here too. Hilary, bonjour. Bombville Lover is with us. Victoria, comment ça va? Desarlika, coucou. Who else? Olga is there too. Yossi just joined. Luciana once again. Cosmina Bellou, Ice Cubes. Victoria Jacques, bonjour, bonjour. B. Kurt, Fiona Adams, Arch. Sharma is with us too. Well, I hope you're doing fine. We'll start right now. So today it will be for beginners. Remember that this first week, we've been starting again this week. So we'll do some des révisions. So we'll try to review a few things. So basically, our exercises that we've been covering during the last semester or the last season or the last chapter, the way you want to call it. D'accord? So we can start right now. Allez, Yann Arte is joining us too. Bonjour Yann, I hope you're doing fine. Stardust is joining too. Sherry Lynn just woke up. Because Sherry Lynn is really far from us. And it's in the middle of the night for her. And she's extremely brave. Allez, the question of the day. It's a classic. I've been asking you this question several times. So that's the reason why during these reviews, I think it could be interesting. Qu'est-ce que vous allez faire après notre cours? Luciana, lunettes bleues. Oui. Trying to find all the colors possible for the glasses because I think it's more fun like that. Alice Desarlika is joining us. Try to answer to this. Qu'est-ce que vous allez faire après notre cours? So what are you going to do after the lesson? Allez-y. Alors, Sherilyn is the first one. Even she, it's the middle of the night for her, but still, she's the first one to answer. And she's writing, je vais dormir, bien sûr. Kirill, je vais me coucher. Notre cours, je vais préparer le dîner. Hilary, je vais travailler. Hilary est courageuse, elle va travailler, félicitations. Gordon, nous mangeons notre curry de poulet. Miam, miam. Bravo. J'ai envie de manger maintenant. Yossi, je vais voir quelques leçons de français sur YouTube. D'accord, effectivement. Rupture. Pourquoi rupture? Est-ce qu'il y a un problème? Alors, apparemment, la connexion est bonne de mon côté. Je ne sais pas si la connexion est bonne de votre côté. Oh, j'en ai marre. « Nous reprenons. L'ordinateur avait décidé de faire une pause. Yossi, donc, il disait que je vais voir quelques leçons de français sur YouTube. Luciana, je vais nager. C'est formidable. Ensuite, Julia qui dit you are frozen. Yeah, because it's too cold outside. This is the reason I was frozen like that. Minus 16 today. Fiona, je vais préparer le dîner. Bickert, probablement que je vais dîner comme d'habitude. Et après, je vais faire de l'exercice de français jusqu'à me coucher. Très bien, Bickert est très très sérieuse. Fizzle, je vais faire des exercices et travailler un peu. You should put travailler in the infinitive form, Fizzle. Mercurial Man, je vais continuer à travailler. C'est très bien. Kate Geek, bonjour, bonjour. Victoria Posse, après le cours, je vais prendre un café avec du lait ou un café crème. Très bien. Bickert Fair, d'accord. Il y a un problème avec la vidéo. C'est fini normalement. Victoria Jacques, je vais préparer un petit déjeuner. J'ai très, très faim. Qu'est-ce que vous mangez, Victoria Jacques? Quand vous petit déjeuner, ce sera intéressant. Ensuite, Ice Cubes, je vais retourner chez moi, prendre une douche, préparer quelque chose à manger, participer à la leçon de chinois, lire quelque chose et regarder une série avant de dormir. Ice Cube, we've been talking about this Lupin série on Netflix. I don't know if you've been watching it. It's quite interesting. In fact, it's not too bad, I think. Let's check the rest now. Desarlika qui dit ça va maintenant. Olga qui dit je vais prendre une douche. Très bien, ma vie est-elle française pendant le confinement? Ashley is joining us. Long time no see, monsieur. Bonjour Vincent et tout le monde. J'espère que tout va bien. Ça fait longtemps. Ça fait longtemps, Ashley. Eh bien oui, c'est fini votre Lupin. Qu'est-ce que ça veut dire? Daria, bonsoir à vous. Allez, on y va. So remember, don't forget to click on the like, because my pleasure would be to try to reach at least maybe 100 likes, which might be challenging today because you're not a lot, but still, let's see. And then if you want to join the community, rejoignez la communauté, you can click, it's right below the video and it's the button join. Merci beaucoup. Allez, how would you translate these little things? Remember, we've been doing that previously because the concept, as I explained, is to do some reviews. Regardez, I like to travel. How could you say that in French? Daria nous dit, je vais faire une promenade. Il y a beaucoup de neige. Ici aussi, beaucoup, beaucoup de neige. Allez-y. Alors, oui. Alors ici, nous sommes d'accord que idéalement, peut-être j'aime bien, j'adore, it's a bit strong, Cosmina, but why not? J'adore, it would be more like I love to travel, but I mean, we agree that it's possible always to negotiate. Ice Cubes is so happy to see Ashley again, but I think he's gone. He's coming just to say hello, he's polite, and after that he's going away. Boo! So in that case, it should be j'aime, j'adore, j'aime bien. And after that, remember that the second verb should come in the infinitive form, so voyager. And remember that we don't put any preposition between the two. So, j'aime voyager. J'adore voyager. J'aime bien voyager. D'accord. Ah non, 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 Ice Cube is answering. Salut, Madame Cube. C'est vrai, Ice Cube, ça c'est Cube. Cube, c'est votre nom de famille. Il est là, Ashley. Je n'ai plus mon jingle de ma Benz. Je suis désolé, Ashley. Allez, on continue. Allez, numéro 2. She watches a Spanish series. How could you say that in French? Translate that, please. Cassandra Chao is joining us. Bonjour, bonjour. You can participate. Merci. Thank you. Alors, Cosmina est la première. Oui, Julia, après, d'accord. Be careful, Julia, because Ceri's feminine. So basically, your adjective espagnol should be in the feminine form. So don't forget, look at your screen. Don't forget that espagnol, as it's an adjective, we have two forms. We've got the masculine that will end with O-L. D'accord? But in that situation, because it's connected to une série, it's a feminine word, so your adjective espagnol should be definitely in the feminine form, so espagnol with a final E. You pronounce them the same way, still you should write it properly. Ashley is going for une émission, offering une série après. Oui, peut-être une série, d'accord? Une émission, it would be more like a show, I guess. Daria qui dit, oh, du tango, I will continue for you, Daria. Just the tango for Daria, and I hope you can dance. Numéro 3, I was lost. Numéro 3, you want to talk to me. How could you say that? You want to talk to me. Joy is joining us and Joy is also from Australia. So it's in the middle of the night. Maybe you should sleep a bit, Joy. Hein? You need to be rested. Pardon. Excusez-moi, Daria, je remets. Alors, it's interesting because we've got different approaches now. Yossi is going, well, actually the same way as me. So he's putting the pronoun before the verb. Of course, the pronoun should be before the verb it's connected to. So, me should be before parler. Tu veux me parler. Victoria Jacques, same thing. I mean, that way. Cosmina is going with another form that could be totally possible. Vous voulez parler avec moi. It's also possible to use this form. Julia is going the same way, so no problem like that. Vous voulez parler avec moi, tu veux parler avec moi, tu veux me parler, vous voulez me parler, everything goes. Ice Cubes, be careful, tu veux, V-E-U-X, hein, remember, we don't pronounce it, but should it should be there. So je veux, remember, it's with X in the end. Tu veux X in the end, but then il, elle, should be with T. Kategeek went for vous voulez, which is totally okay. Gordon, be careful, Gordon. It's not a question in that case. So we need to keep the normal order. Subject, verb, and the rest. So whether you will go with vous voulez, or then yeah, because the idea would be to use voulez. Hein. Vous voulez parler avec moi, or then vous voulez me parler. Tu veux parler avec moi, tu veux me parler. Remember that the pronouns should be before the verbs. And Gordon, if you've got a doubt with that, so this pronoun is a pronoun complément d'objet indirect. Have a look at my videos, I explain it quite precisely. Numéro 4, on y va. We can't come. Allez-y, comment est-ce que vous pouvez traduire ça? Alors, Yossi is definitely having a really fast router now. Hein, Yossi, c'est rapide. Bravo, Yossi. Effectivement, nous ne pouvons pas venir. So let's agree that in that case, you've been forgetting the pas, Yossi. This is the only thing. The negative form, ne pas, is impacting. Okay, so you've been putting it after. Is impacting the first verb. So the first verb is pouvoir. Pouvoir, can. You will start with the ne, then you put your verb pouvons, and you close it with the pas. Remember, it will go before and after for the negative form. nous ne pouvons pas venir. D'accord. So Ice Cube is going for on ne peut pas venir. Yulia is going for on ne peut pas venir. We agree that in most of the cases when we talk, and if it's informal, this is the main point, hein, remember, if it's not formal, then we would rather use on instead of nous. D'accord. But still, as you know, in most of the cases, we should be translated with nous. Let's go for nous if it's possible. And after that, we can take some liberty with the language. Allez, on continue. Renato Silva is joining us. Bonsoir, bonjour. Numéro 5. Numéro 5. Why, this one is extremely simple. Let's see how you would translate that. I am at home. I am at home. How could you say that? D'accord, so it seems that everybody wants to go, or almost everybody, with the preposition chez, and then after that, obviously, we will put moi. Yossi wants to translate it directly, je suis à la maison, which it's totally correct. No problem. Ange Gabriel wants to go with the chuis. I mean, it's okay, no worries, but then obviously you will not write that if you are asking for a job. So let's agree on that. The idea, of course, is to take some liberty with the language. It's not a problem. It's never a problem. The language is just a tool. But the concept is to be able to adapt to all the context and all the situations. And if you tend to take a lot of liberties with the language at the beginning, it would be extremely difficult for you to go to the formal language, and so in some cases you might end up in strange situations, and it's not really a good image that you give to the others. So it's just for me, taking liberties with the language, no problem. I mean, this is the concept, huh? But be aware that it's always good to master the correct form first. So let's go for the numéro 6. Numéro 6, I have 2 cats and 3 dogs. Allez-y. Alors, Cosmina est la première et je dis bravo. Yulia is right after. Bonville lover. Be careful, Yulia. You were a bit too generous with the chat. Hein? Only one day, if possible. So, j'ai 2 chats et 3 chiens. I mean, this one was extremely simple, I think. So, of course, you want to put the verb avoir. You want to put that in the present form. So, j'ai. And after that, deux, well, obviously, you write it properly, D-E-U-X, I'm looking at your things. Sundar is joining us, bonjour, bonjour. And then trois chiens. Don't forget to put the S for chat, because, of course, it will be the mark of the plural. So chat, C-H-A-T-S. And then chien, same thing here. Hein? Remember, the basic form, C-H-I-E-N, but then you will add the S for the plural. So, j'ai 2 chats et 3 chiens. Pas de problème. Allez, on continue. Numéro 7. Numéro 7. Well, this one is actually quite simple. My name is Isabelle. Alors, Yossi is the first one, and yes, Yossi, you're starting with the verb s'appeler, remember, pronominal verb, hein? Reflexive verb, so basically the verb is s'appeler. When we conjugate s'appeler, for the 3 first persons, remember, we'll have to double the L, hein? This is the tricky thing, so you've been doing it quite well so far. So, je m'appelle, 2 L, Isabelle. So, Luciana wants to go with mon prénom est Isabelle. It's totally possible. Renato goes with the mon nom est Isabelle. So you got all these options. I mean, this is good. Mon nom est Isabelle. Mon prénom est Isabelle. Je m'appelle Isabelle. In most of the cases, if you introduce yourself to other persons, well, we will use the verb s'appeler. Je m'appelle. Je suis. You could also go for je suis Isabelle. Allez, let's hook numéro 8. Numéro 8, we speak English. This one is simple. Hein? Alors, same thing here. Hein? We're using the we, so basically, let's go for the nous if you want. Ice Cube wants to take some liberties because Ice Cube is a free person. She decides to say, no, I want to go for on, which is totally okay. We agree, it's not a problem. So basically, whether you go for nous, so in that case, the verb is parler, parler really, really regular. So nous parlons anglais. Oh, then, on parle anglais. Keep in mind, Luciana, that when we're talking about the languages, Berila, it's the same. Cosmina Bellutu, we don't put any capital letter for the languages. D'accord? So, in that case, it should be with a small a. Anglais, A-N-G-L-A-I-S. We will put the capital in French. Not when we're talking about the languages, not when we're talking about or we're using them as adjectives, no capital letters then. But if we're talking about the substantive, the nouns, the people, in that case, we will put the capital letter. So, anglais, un anglais, an Englishman, une anglaise, an English lady, in that case, you will put the capital letter. D'accord? Allez, numéro 9. Numéro 9. Oh, it's really good. It is really good. How could you say that in French? Alors, let's have a look. Julia is the first one. C'est bon. Yeah, you could emphasize with the vraiment. So, vraiment as Yossi is using. Yeah. So, vraiment, it's an adverb. And it's funny because the adverbs, remember, it's also possible to use the adverbs to combine them and modify the intensity of adjectives. Hein? So, in that case, this is exactly what we're doing. C'est vraiment. Hein? So, it's the idea of this. Really bon. Remember that we're going for the adjective because it's not bien, but it's really bon. We need to have the adjective in that case. C'est très bon. Luciana, yeah. Très would be more like very, but still, I mean, it's the same. It is the concept and it's quite good. C'est très bon. C'est vraiment bon. Gordon is going for il est. Be careful, Gordon. In most of the cases, we're not using the il like that. We agree that il can be also, in some cases, used for this impersonal concept, but still it's extremely rare. If you really want to talk about something and say that it is, go for c'est, because in most of the cases this is the form that you will use. C'est très bon, d'accord? And remember, Gordon, this is for you, because you are using c'est, even if you're talking about something that is feminine, we don't really care, because the structure c'est will only, allow you to use an adjective in the masculine form. D'accord? C'est très bon. Hein? C'est très beau, c'est très chaud, etc., etc. So I'm looking at the others, and still it's quite good. Andrius, be careful. It's not c'est très bien, but it's c'est très bon. Hein? We're not expecting the adverb in that case. We're expecting the adjective. This is extremely, extremely important. Numéro 10. Numéro 10. Well, it's a classic one, this one. What time is it? What time is it? Allez, allez-y. Alors, Riena, bonjour, le professeur perd sa voix. Mais non! Regardez, la la la! Non, 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 ça va. Non, non, la voix, c'est OK. It's always a bit broken. Just like my life. Alors, what time is it? The classic one is, quelle heure est-il? Remember, Berilla, we don't use the verb faire in that case, but it's really the expression être. Quelle heure est-il? Luciana, be careful, you've been forgetting the E at the end of heure. Hilary, you were extremely generous with heure because you've been putting this beautiful S that should not be there. D'accord? Quelle heure est-il? Remember that heure is feminine, so basically it means that your quelle should be in the feminine form. Q-U-E-L-L-E. D'accord? Quelle heure est-il? I'm looking at the others. So far, so good. Kirill, be careful. Hein? Don't forget the E at the end of your quel. Yanarte, we're not really going for the temps in that case. It's really the when we're asking for the time in this situation, in French, we're using this hour concept. Quelle heure est-il? Quelle heure est-il? Merci beaucoup. Alors, let's agree on that. You're 84 right now, 85 persons, and I've got only 52 likes, and this is not reasonable. So please click on like. You know that my little pleasure is to have at least, if possible, 100 likes. Merci beaucoup. This is your way of thanking me, of saying, continuez, Vincent, continuez. And of course, you can buy me a coffee. It would be so nice because I love coffee. So you know that you can click on the join and join the community. Just buy me a coffee. It will be really, really nice. Merci. Allez, what do they do? So let's see how it works, this one. Because basically, I wanted to have a little video here. And I think it should work now. Or maybe not. Well, if it's not working, then in that case, you can just imagine. What do they do? Que font-ils? Write me a beautiful sentence to tell me what they are doing right now. Allez-y. Alors, Indefi TV is joining us. Bonjour, bonjour. Just participate. Thank you very much. Alors, Yulia is the first one to say, oh, mais il prépare une fondue pour Ashley. Eh oui, oh, we remember this time when Ashley was telling us, oh yeah, come to Switzerland and then we'll have this fondue together. I went there, he was not there. Voilà, c'est ce que je dis. I don't want to say anything more. Ensuite, Yossi, il prépare un repas ensemble. Et oui, c'est vrai, très bien écrit. Gordon, le garçon et la fille font le déjeuner. Remember that, Gordon, you should definitely conjugate your verb faire, but in the plural form, font, F-O-N-T, third person of the plural. Bickert, ils font du camping et ils préparent le repas pour dîner ensemble. C'est magnifique. Ange Gabriel qui nous dit, ils préparent le café. Pourquoi pas? Pourquoi pas? It will be an interesting coffee, this one, but I'm looking at the videos at the same time. So. Catégique, il cuisine au pique-nique, d'accord. Ensuite, Fiona, il prépare le dîner. Riena, il verse de la bière dans un pot. Non, de la bière chaude. Est-ce que c'est bon? I never tried, I mean, like, hot beer, why not? Pourquoi pas? On ne sait pas. Ensuite, je regarde. Qui est-ce qui avait écrit Rajni, ils font la cuisine ensemble. La fille verse la purée de chocolat, peut-être. Ah, je ne sais pas, oui. Renato, il prépare mon dîner. Oh, ben voilà. Renato va avoir un dîner très intéressant. Bombville Lover, ils font du camping et cuisinent leur repas. Très bien. Hillary qui nous dit, ils font du camping et cuisinent. Only one hand, Hillary, for cuisiner. Luciana, est-ce qu'il prépare une fondue? Oui, il prépare une fondue pour Monsieur Ashley. Mais on ne peut jamais manger de fondue avec Ashley. Cosmina, ils font des expériences avec de l'huile de voiture. C'est possible. Une expérience gastronomique avec de l'huile de voiture. Ensuite, Inde qui nous dit, il prépare un gâteau au chocolat, peut-être. Olga qui dit, je n'ai aucune idée. Ok, Victoria Possé, ils font la nourriture en camping. Cassandra, ils préparent un repas pendant qu'ils campent. Probablement, oui, regardez. Ensuite, je regarde. Victoria Jacques, ils campent et cuisinent de la soupe, peut-être. Daria, ils sont en train de cuisiner quelque chose de sain et délicieux. Sérieusement, Daria, ils passent un bon moment ensemble, ça leur fait plaisir. Vous, Slat, ils préparent le petit déjeuner ensemble. Yesero qui dit, attention, il y a trop d'huile. Est-ce que c'est de l'huile, à votre avis? Peut-être, on ne sait pas. Ça va être bizarre, en tout cas, ce qu'ils mangent. Je regarde les autres. Alors, attendez. De l'huile, d'huile. Attendez, tout le monde discute maintenant. Bickert, peut-être qu'ils utilisent de la nourriture en boîte, probablement. Et Daria qui dit on apprend de ses erreurs. Très bien. Berilla, ils font de la randonnée et dans le camp ils se nourrissent en faisant de la nourriture sur une cuisine tempête. Qu'est-ce que c'est une cuisine tempête? Je ne sais pas. Est-ce que vous voulez dire un camping gaz, comme on dit, hein? Cheryline, ils fabriquent des réactifs à l'extérieur parce qu'ils ont oublié d'en faire au laboratoire. Il y a un échantillon qu'ils doivent analyser immédiatement. C'est comme ça que vous faites. Alors, Cheryline, jamais je n'irai me promener avec vous si vous commencez à préparer des réactifs. Non. Allez, le verbe du jour, so the verb of the day is prendre. Prendre is to take, it's a really common verb. In that case, I thought it might be interesting, of course. I mean, these are the tenses that normally you should master if you want to reach an advanced level. But in our case, we'll only focus in that case today on présent, futur simple, and then passé composé. But for a change, so before you start writing anything, look, we'll start with the present, and then I would like to cover all the persons. So we'll take the time to cover all the persons. Please give me je, tu, il, and elle, and on, obviously, for the present of prendre. Nicolas was asking me, when are you done? And I say, well, we'll still have 40 minutes to go. Alors, we agree that in that case, we have the three forms. So far, so good. So, je prends, and remember, DS, Tu prends des S, il, elle prend des. We pronounce them exactly the same way, but still, keep in mind that we should definitely write them like that. So, je prends, tu prends, il, elle prend. DS, DS, D. And so far, it's quite good. So, you probably know that, well, the second part will be obviously to have nous, vous, il, and elle. Give me that for the same verb, hein, prendre, allez-y. Alors, je regarde. So far, so good. The tricky thing, remember, with prendre is for the third person of the plural. Because for the, well, for nous, it will be nous prenons, only one N. Vous prenez, only one N. And the tricky thing for the third person of the plural, you'll have to double the N. And so, first you need to remember to write it. But then, the most important is that it impacts the pronunciation. Because when you've got and then double N right after, double consonant, it will open the sound of the E. So you'll pronounce prenne, E. So remember, so nous prenons E because only one N. Vous prenez E because only one N. Ils prennent E because you get two N's. Elles prennent the same thing. So keep in mind that you will have to really, really double the N. And Ice Cubes is decided to change totally the rules of the conjugation for this verb because Ice Cubes want to have il prend. And it's interesting. In fact, it could be possible. Il prend doesn't sound that nice. Il prend, but and sorry, Ice Cubes, it doesn't work in that case. Let's agree on the fact that it should be il prenne. Merci beaucoup. Allez, let's have a look now at the future simple. Future simple, remember the real future. And whoops, I was too fast. Exactly the same thing. We'll do je, tu, il, elle. And then after that, we'll have nous, vous, il, elle. But let's focus first on the singular. Alors, Dark Tainer is joining us. Bonsoir à vous. J'espère que vous allez bien. Alors, well, the things that I start to see are extremely good. So the concept in that case for prendre, to get the root, to get the stem, will be to remove the final E. So you just remove it, and then after that, you will just need to add the endings. The endings, remember, for the future simple, AI for je, AS for tu, and A for il, elle. So it means that when you will combine prendre, your root, with the terminations, the endings, so you will get je prendrai, I will take, tu prendras, il prendra, elle prendra. Remember that in fact you will pronounce the tu form prendra with this final S and the il, elle form prendra the same way. You still need to write the final S for tu. Je prendrai, tu prendras, il prendra, elle prendra. You've been forgetting the N for your tu form. I am monitoring your things, hein? In day, FITV, be careful, il, elle prendra. You've been having a little mistake. So let's continue with nous, vous, il, and elle. Allez-y. Alors, I can see that Bickert, Yossi, and then Cosmina started to already post the thing, Rajni too. So, look, in fact, we keep the same root. So, it's always P-R-E-N-D-R, the root, but then the endings will change. So, O-N-S for nous, nous prendrons. E-Z for vous, vous prendrez. And then O-N-T for il, elle, ils prendront. Elles prendront, and that's the way it will go. Remember that phonetically, the nous form prendront, O-N-S, and the il, elle form for the plural prendront, O-N-T, are exactly the same. You write them differently, but you pronounce them exactly the same way. Allez, let's continue with the passé composé. Remember, compound tense, so it means that I'm expecting je, tu, il, and elle. Merci. Alors, let's have a look at your form. So it's a compound tense. It does mean that we'll have to use a helping verb. In French, we've got two helping verbs. It's whether avoir, in most of the cases, or then être. In that situation, prendre is not really a tricky verb because, like most of the verbs, it will use the helping verb avoir. So it means that you will have to put avoir in the present. So you will conjugate avoir in the present, j'ai, tu. A, il, elle, a. And because it is a compound tense, it means that you have a second part that you need to use. This second part is called the participe passé, the past participle, which for prendre is pris. It means that this past participle will be there all the time and you will have to put it all the time. So, j'ai pris, tu as pris, il a pris. Pris, elle a pris. D'accord? Allez, let's finish the conjugation with the nous, vous, il and elle form for the verb prendre one more time. Alors, I can see that you've been putting your things already, so it's quite good. So, we continue with the same logic. We know that now we are using the helping verb avoir, so we just need to conjugate avoir in the present. And then the second part will still be this past participle form pris that we have previously. So, nous avons, present form of avoir, pris. Past participle of prendre. Vous avez pris, and then ils ont pris, elles ont pris. Voilà. J'ai pris, tu as pris, il, elle a pris, nous avons pris, vous avez pris, ils ont pris, elles ont pris. Merci beaucoup. Alors, it is true. It is true that now I am extremely motivated because I can see that I've got already 85 likes, but then you know that my objective would be to have 100 likes, and I think it's possible. So please, please, please click on the likes just to thank me, to support me, to say, vas-y Vincent, and then if you want to join the community, it's quite simple. You just need to click on the join, and it's right below the video. Allez, on continue with the picture of the day. The picture of the day, as you know, it's a picture, and then you just need to write me one beautiful sentence to tell me what you can see in this video. « Alors, Tom is telling us, I really like to study French. Thanks. It's my pleasure, Tom. Try, because the key when you learn a language, the key is to try to be, well, active, bold and brave and try to write a little thing. So you can participate. Don't worry if you make mistakes, it's totally okay. Nobody will judge you here. I mean, the spirit is quite good. People are nice to each other. We support each other. So make mistakes. This is the best way to learn. D'accord? Alors, regardons, let's have a look. Nico is the first one to say, le chat voit la lune. Oui, d'accord. So remember the difference between voir and regarder. Voir, it's to see. Regarder would be more like to watch, so it's up to you. Still, the sentence is extremely, extremely correct. Vouslat, le chat regarde la lune pendant la nuit. Très bien. Gordon, le chat, assis. Be careful, it's assis, A-S-S-I-S. Dans l'arbre devant la lune, oui. Olga, she's just, yeah, I mean, we are extremely close to the 100 likes. We will make it. Luciana, un chat regarde la lune pleine. Oui, la pleine lune. The expression goes like that. Hein, la pleine lune sur un arbre. Dark Tainer qui dit, un chat regarde la lune. Alors, Dark Tainer, remember that it's possible in French to have whether the masculine or the feminine when we're talking about the cats. Same thing for the dogs. So, un chat, masculine form, or then une chatte. So, un chat will be written exactly the way you wrote it, Dark Tainer. If you want to put the feminine, une chatte, you will have to double your T and then finish with E. D'accord? T-T-E. This is the way it goes. Yossi, un chat est assis sur un arbre. Il rêve la lumière de la lune. C'est vrai. Est-ce que les chats rêvent, Yossi? Probablement. Bonville Lover, un chat s'assoit sur un arbre devant la lune. Humei, le chat sur l'arbre dans la nuit. Ouais, remember, Humei, that dans, D-A-N-S. Don't forget the S, you don't pronounce it, still it should be there. Kategik, le chat sur la branche regarde la lune. Fiona Adams, le hibou est devenu un chat. It's a great idea, Fiona. Mais c'est une belle photo. Le chat profite de la belle lune. Oui, peut-être que c'était un hibou et hop, il s'est transformé. Dahir, un chat sur l'arbre. Très bien. Fahad Nazir, ce soir, un chat sur l'arbre à la pleine lune. Très bien. Rajni, il y a un chat qui est assis devant la belle lune. Très bien. Fatima, bonjour Fatima, participez au cours s'il vous plaît. Riema, le chat est assis sur la branche. Daria, le chat est assis sur un arbre et regarde la lune. C'est une très belle image. Oui. Je trouvais que c'était sympathique comme image, avec des couleurs, des formes, c'était assez intéressant. Ice Cubes, la lune est très belle dans cette image, et le chat sur l'arbre aussi. On voit juste l'ombre. Hein. Victoria Jacques, une belle image d'une pleine lune et d'un chat sur un arbre. Très bien, bah écoutez, merci beaucoup, nous allons continuer. Let's remember that we still need 4 likes to reach the 100, and I would be so pleased. So if you didn't click yet on the like, go for it. Merci. And sometimes we need to learn how to say no. If it's not in your nature, then it's difficult, but then we need to learn that. And obviously by that, I mean that we need to work on the negative form. So let's have a look at, we will only cover these four forms. So it will be present, passé composé, futur proche, and passé récent. You will see the reason why. The first one, it's the present. Obviously, je in the present form for the indicative. Je prends. I would like you to write only the negative form of this verb. Je prends. Allez-y. Alors, Tom is saying, I would like you to speak French much more than English because we would like to acquire French. Yes. So, Tom, let's agree on that. We've been doing these lives for quite a long time now. And the way it goes, it's extremely simple. Now it's twice per week. We'll have the lessons in English. So it's on Monday and it's today on Thursday. After that, tomorrow we'll continue, but it will be in French. And then the day after, it will be in French. So you just need to come at the proper day and the proper time. It's the same time, but still this is the concept. The concept is that in some cases, this is for beginners now, so it's in English. Tomorrow it will be for intermediate, and now I've been switching to French. And after that, on Saturday, it will be for advanced, and it will be only in French. So you just pick the day according to your needs, d'accord? But we've been keeping this concept of Monday and Thursday in English. Allez, regardons. So we agree that in that case, yes, the way to go is to put ne pas. In that situation, it's extremely simple because you have only one formal verb, so it starts with je, obviously the subject, first part of the negative form ne, then you squeeze your verb right after, prend, and you finish with pas. So it's extremely simple here, no trick. Let's have a look at passé composé. Passé composé, it is quite interesting because it's a compound tense, d'accord? So j'ai pris. How would you put the negative form when we have a compound tense? Alors, I'm looking at your answers. So that's the reason why I was a bit silent. Was just checking. In most of the cases, everyone is totally right. So remember that the way it goes in French with the negative form for the compound tenses. Ne and pas are the two things that you need to use to create this negative concept. So it means that ne will be before your helping verb and pas will be after your helping verb. It means that right after your pas, you will put your past participle. So this is the reason why it is like that on your screen. Je n'ai pas pris. The common mistake is to finish with the pas, so to put pas after pris, and it's not the way it should be done, d'accord? Still, people will understand, but still, it will be a mistake. So, je n'ai pas pris. D'accord? And it will be like that for all the other compound tenses, because we've got several. And if you want to work on them, remember, it's for the advanced. We're covering all the tenses. Allez, let's have a look at future proche. Future proche is quite interesting because in that case, we're using two verbs. It's not a compound tense. It's really two different verbs. So basically, je vais prendre. How will you put the negative form of this form? Alors, everything seems to be quite okay and quite good, in fact. So we agree that in that case, the negative form will impact the first conjugated verb, which makes sense in that case. So, je ne vais pas. So you will put the negative form on aller, vais, conjugated. And then you just put your infinitive verb right after, prendre. Je ne vais pas prendre. So let's have a look now at the last one, passé récent. Passé récent, same thing. Hein? It's two verbs, but then, of course, I want to be tricky because now we've got this preposition, the. So let's see how you will dance with this beautiful form. Je viens de prendre. How could you put the negative form? Alors, Humay is asking, when can we use the future proche? Future proche is exactly like in English, I am going to. So by using this future proche, in fact, you're making this concept closer to you. So it means that it's more certain than a real future. So like in English, I will do something, or that I am going to do something, you've got the feeling that I am going to do it, like in French, je vais faire, is more certain because clearly it is closer to you. So same thing here, je viens de prendre, and so I can see that everything is okay for you, je ne viens pas. Pas. So remember, we don't keep the preposition close to the verb. We're sealing the negative form with the pas right after the verb. Je ne viens pas. Boom. And after that, you continue with the preposition de, and then your infinitive prendre. Je ne viens pas de prendre. Everything is okay. Hein? Félicitations. Bravo, bravo. And then we've been reaching the 100 likes. I am so, so happy. Merci beaucoup. Allez, let's continue with the quote of the day. The quote of the day is from a person that is extremely important in France. I mean, this person passed away, but still he played a big, big role in France, and he's called l'Abbé Pierre. So if you are familiar with this organization, Emmaüs, I don't know if you've got an Emmaüs in your country. It does exist in several countries beside France, but he's the founder of this association, which is extremely, extremely nice. So, and he says, un sourire coûte moins cher que l'électricité, mais donne autant de lumière. You can see the translation right below. Un sourire coûte moins cher que l'électricité, mais donne autant de lumière. And now it's your turn, because I would like to know exactly what do you think about this quote from l'Abbé Pierre. Qu'en pensez-vous? Write me a little sentence, or then just few words, allez-y. Alors, Gordon qui nous dit « c'est bon pour sourire », d'accord, très bien. Yesero qui dit « c'est une bonne phrase ». Daria qui aime bien les citations. It was for you, Daria. Je suis tout à fait d'accord. Une citation magnifique. Player, like we support each other with just a smile. Yes. So, but the idea, player, would be to say what you think about it. Attendez. Bombil Lover, je pense que c'est une phrase très gentille et vraie. Riema, un sourire illumine la journée de chacun. Eh ouais. Hilary, j'aime la citation. Je voudrais voir son sourire. Rory, une personne qui sourit tout le temps est un cadeau pour tout le monde. Et oui. Luciana qui nous dit, c'est une très belle citation. Nico, alors, mais donne plus de lumière. I don't know if that's right. Oui, donne plus de lumière. Si, si, Nico, it's good, it's good. Fiona, malheureusement, les gens ont oublié de sourire. Mais peut-être que les gens sont un peu tristes. Ah, la situation est bizarre. Julia, ça dépend. Parce que quand Arnold Schwarzenegger sourit, c'est plus bizarre que lumineux. On avait dit pas de nom. Chérilyn, ce n'est... Alors attendez, ce n'est vrai que si un sourire qui atteint le sourire, qui attend les yeux, sinon il n'est pas sincère. Ah, vous voulez dire le sourire comme ça et le sourire avec les yeux? Ouais. Tom, meilleur prof... Oh, bah écoutez Tom, ça me fait plaisir. I'm happy to be your teacher, Tom. But come, definitely come... Tomorrow and the day after, if you want, it will be in French. Yossi, il y a quelqu'un qui a dit « Un jour sans sourire est un jour perdu ». Moi, je suis d'accord, Yossi. Stardust, une phrase vraie que je ressens encore et encore, à quel point les gens sont heureux d'un peu d'attention. Ben oui, et si c'est juste un sourire, ça fait briller les visages. Humei, c'est une phrase courte, mais avec un sens de fond. Bah oui. Rajni, un sourire change vraiment l'ambiance de l'endroit et des gens autour qui peuvent le sentir. Vousla, dans le sens figuré, je suis tout à fait d'accord avec cette citation. Berilla 71, un sourire, c'est comme un trou dans la nuit. J'aime bien ce concept, Berilla, merci. Alors, Dahir, faire sourire vachement est vachement important. D'accord, ah, vous l'avez utilisé vachement. Salut de San Diego, bonjour, bonjour, participez. You can participate. B. Moët. Ice Cubes, d'accord, mais c'est pas une bonne comparaison. Non, 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 on a besoin de l'électricité pour pouvoir voir ton sourire. Ah oui, c'est vrai. Mais les deux sont utiles, peut-être. Ange, je suis d'accord avec lui, Cosmina Bellou. Un sourire illumine le visage et les yeux. Métaphorique, un sourire crée une atmosphère agréable et détendue. Kirill, est-ce qu'en français l'électricité est bon marché? Ah, je ne suis pas un spécialiste hein, des comparaisons internationales du prix de l'électricité. I'm not a specialist, Kiri, about that. I guess you can have a look at some websites. They will give you the comparison per countries. Olga Ruiz, c'est vrai que quelqu'un veut sourire, d'accord, be curt. Oui, un sourire est important. Toujours, et sourire avec le visage donne la lumière et une énergie autour. Yulia, ce serait merveilleux si l'ordinateur pouvait marcher quand vous souriez seulement. Et quand on ne sourit plus, ça s'arrête. Ça, c'est une bonne idée, peut-être. Allez, let's try to imagine what does she say. Allez, hop, regardez, c'est une vidéo, it's a video, so just imagine. Que dit-elle? Give me one sentence to try to tell me what does she say. Allez, c'est Fatima qui commence et Fatima nous dit, elle parle, remember to conjugate your verb, Fatima, elle parle, P-A-R-L-E, avec son mari, hein, masculine form, son, because mari is masculine, mercurial, elle dit peut-être, Victoria Possé, elle dit que notre nourriture était délicieuse au camping, avec l'huile, comme imaginait Cosmina. Riema, tu es drôle et mignon. Hilary, tu me donnes le diamant quand? Bah oui, mais ils sont dans une tente. Hilary, they're in a tent. Maybe she's not going to get the diamond. Mais bon, on ne sait pas. On ne sait pas. Fiona Adams, est-ce que mes cheveux sont beaux? This is exactly what I'm asking every day, but nobody is answering to me. I don't know why. Ensuite, Stardust, elle dit qu'elle est heureuse de pouvoir enfin passer du temps seule avec lui et à quel point elle l'apprécie. Rajni, quand je regarde, don't forget the E in the final position, t'es dans tes yeux, ma mère me manque. C'est bizarre, c'est une phrase bizarre. So when I look in your eyes, my mother, I miss my mother. C'est intéressant. Une phrase très, très romantique. Ange Gabriel, demain, c'est quand le live? Same time. Ange Gabriel, just go to the channel and you can see the three lives that we'll have tomorrow. Tomorrow and the day after tomorrow. Yann Arte, elle dit, quel beau voyage masculin, beau, beau, beau. Daria, elle prévoit pour quelque chose pour l'avenir. Elle partage ses rêves avec lui. Ils sont ensemble, c'est essentiel pour eux. Eh oui. Humei, elle explique une nouvelle idée à son partenaire masculin, partenaire, son. Hein, look at the person, it's a man. Vuslat, je suis très contente que nous faisions le pique-nique ici. La nature est si belle. Desarlika, elle passe du bon temps avec son mari. Remember that it should be son mari, because we determine the gender of this adjective son according to the word. So basically, mari is masculine, so it means that it will be mon mari, ton mari, son mari. So it will be the masculine because the word mari is masculine. Yesero, elle dit, quelle aventure! Cosmina, elle dit qu'elle n'est pas elle, mais qu'elle est il. Don't get it. Est-ce que c'est avec la fluidité des genres? Je ne sais pas. Rory, elle dit, chérie, un ours dehors, je vais sourire. Alors tu n'as pas peur. Rory, est-ce qu'il y a des ours là où vous êtes? Faites attention, hein. Les rencontres avec les ours, c'est toujours dangereux. Fatima, elle parle avec son mari, très bien. Luciana, elle dit que le bonheur est simple, comme une tente, c'est vrai. Yossi, elle veut savoir combien son petit ami l'aime. Omar, bonjour, bonjour, elle dit qu'il était très loin de la vérité. Ah, peut-être. Olga, elle dit, nous avons notre amour. Ice Cubes, elle dit, c'est pas important ce que tu m'as dit maintenant. Tu souris. Ah, ton sourire est très beau. Très bien. Ensuite, dommage, je veux avoir 6 enfants juste pour te préparer. Juste pour ton information, j'en veux 6. Ensuite, player, quand vous allez changer votre voiture. Berilla, elle dit qu'elle a oublié d'emballer la nourriture. Peut-être. Les fourmis vont arriver. Allez, on continue. Alors, n'oubliez pas de cliquer, s'il vous plaît. N'oubliez pas de cliquer. Oui, 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 Ice Cube. J'ai l'impression qu'il y avait une histoire de fluidité des genres dans ce que Cosmina disait. Mais pourquoi pas? Alors, Sony, est-ce que quelqu'un peut m'expliquer le concept de ce live, s'il vous plaît? Eh bien, ce sont des exercices. Ce sont des exercices. So we're doing some exercises. And it's every day from Monday to Saturday. Sometimes it's in French, only in French, because it's for intermediate and advanced. And then on Monday and Thursday, it's in English, because it's for beginners. Merci. Allez, we were waiting for this one, the dictation of the day. The dictation of the day, well, as you know, I will read some sentences. These are sentences that we've been working on already. And then I will read them twice. You just need to write them. And the first one is, je prends le train avec elle. Je prends le train avec elle. So try to write it. Merci. Wow, I am so surprised by Yossi, because it goes so fast now with your router. I mean, félicitations, Yossi. Hein? It goes really fast. Cosmina, I mean, well, she's got the vaccine and the 5G, so of course it goes fast too. Alors, in that case, I wanted to go with the verb prendre, hein, the one that we saw. And then, so we agree that when you conjugate that in the present form, je prends, P-R-E-N-D-S. Then, le train should not be really difficult. Avec, normally this preposition is not a problem. And then, elle, obviously. Très bien. Sonia qui nous dit, je serai bientôt de enseignante de français. J'étais en train de chercher des vidéos. Ok, bon courage, Sonia, ça va marcher, vous inquiétez pas. Enseigner le FLE, c'est formidable. Allez, on continue, let's have a look at the second one. Second one is... Eh oui, Yossi a aussi fait le vaccin, Cosmina dit. And it's true, Yossi has got the vaccine, and that's the reason why Cosmina is in second position, Yossi first position, because they've been vaccinated. I am just waiting for it now. Allez, numéro 2, attention, nous allons manger avec eux. Nous allons manger avec eux. Write me the sentence, please. D'accord, hein? So because it's the beginner level, so I don't want to give you, difficult sentences. So in that case, remember the verb is manger. In this situation, I wanted to put this future proche. Remember, future proche, we're using the verb aller that will conjugate in the present. So nous allons. Second thing, of course, manger in the infinitive, because it's coming right after allons. Then avec, remember that what comes after this preposition, avec, will be what we'll call les pronoms toniques. Avec moi, avec toi, avec lui, avec elle, avec nous, avec vous, avec eux, and this is the one, so masculine plural, E-U-X, avec elle, feminine plural. So in that case, it was eux. Nous allons manger avec eux. Très bien. I'm looking at your things. No, so far so good. Remember, Gordon, your manger should be in the infinitive. D'accord? So you should put the R. Remember, the form for the infinitive of manger is M-A-N-G-E-R. Allez, let's have a look at the next sentence. So the next sentence, exactly the same thing here. I will read it twice. Elles viennent de les rencontrer. Elles viennent de les rencontrer. Allez, write the sentence. Alors, yeah, I'm looking at your things and it's usually a common difficulty to really feel the difference, especially when we're talking about the pronouns in that case, whether it's le or les. I tried to be as clear as I could to emphasize on the fact that it was les, the plural, and not le. It seems that some of you heard the le. Don't worry, it's a common mistake because the difference between the two is extremely, extremely thin. So, elles viennent. So in that case, it's the verb venir because as you can see, this is the past, the recent past. Elles viennent de les, and it's the plural form, rencontrer. Rencontrer should be in the infinitive form because it's coming after venir that is conjugated. Okay? And then your pronoun les should be definitely before your verb rencontrer because remember, les in that situation is pronoun complément d'objet direct. Elles viennent de les. Rencontrer. Be careful with the les, and it was not le. So if I make the difference between the two, just to be clear, elles viennent de le rencontrer. Elles viennent de les rencontrer. Hume is asking de plus les égale des. Non, Hume, because in that situation, les, here, it's not an article. It is not an article at all, it's a pronoun. It's pronoun complément d'objet direct. And it's extremely important that this pronoun must stay here, because basically after that I won't understand anything. So, elles viennent de me rencontrer. Elles viennent de te rencontrer. Elles viennent de le rencontrer. Elles viennent de la rencontrer. Elles viennent de nous rencontrer. Elles viennent de vous rencontrer. Elles viennent de les rencontrer. In that situation, because it's not an article at all, you must keep the les. It's a pronoun. Allez, on continue. On continue avec the next one. And the next one is this one. Je ne veux pas le faire. Je ne veux pas le faire. Write, please, the sentence. Voilà, so same thing here, because you know that I like to squeeze as many pronouns as I can. So it's exactly the same thing here. Hein? Je ne veux pas, so we've got the negative form. That impacts, in fact, the first verb, so conjugated, so je ne veux pas. And then second verb, so faire, that must be in the infinitive form, because it's coming right after veux, that is conjugated. And then le, the pronoun, obviously should be there. It's a pronom complément d'objet direct, one more time. So, je ne veux pas le faire. It could be possible, Gordon, to say je ne veux pas la faire. It means that in that situation, la should be replacing something that was mentioned before and that is feminine. D'accord? Je ne veux pas le faire. Je ne veux pas la faire. In that situation, I wanted to pronounce the le, d'accord? Je ne veux pas le faire. Why? Ice cubes. Ice cubes, and she continues the sentence. Parce que je suis libre, nous dit Ice cubes. Allez, let's agree, let's not forget to click on the like if you did not do it before. It's your last chance to say thank you, because I think it was really a nice lesson that we had together. Remember that you can join the community. You just need to click on the join button that is right below the video. Remember that this week, as every week, it's at the same time, so basically these are the times that will have the lesson, or the time, because it will be 4 p.m. Paris, or then if you're on the other side, well, in the US it's 10 a.m. and then in New Delhi it will be 8:30 p.m. So tomorrow it will be in French, and the day after it will be in French. Merci beaucoup. Et à demain. So enjoy your evening, your day, or your night. And some persons should definitely go back to bed. Merci beaucoup. Au revoir. Learn French. Learn today. Learn for free. Learn your way. Learn French with Vincent. Let's go. The best French teacher on the low. Learn French. Learn today. Learn for free. Learn your way. Learn French with Vincent, let's go. The best French teacher on the low. Learning French is simple and free. Learn French with Vincent, A to Z. Easy, fun, 1, 2, 3. Subscribe to the channel to support me. Students all around the world learning fast. Young to old, I am the best. Learning French is simple and free. Learn French with Vincent, A to Z. Learn French with Vincent today.
Any ideas?